In this illustration, we'll analyze the superposition of three waves where we are given that three coherent waves of equal intensities I naught superpose on a medium particle, and we are given that a phase difference between first and second is 30 degrees, with second wave ahead in phase than first, and phase difference between first and third is 45 degrees, with third wave lagging in phase than first. So, we are required to find the resulting sound intensity at the point of superposition. Here, we can simply analyze the situation as if waves are of amplitude A. This implies we can write intensity I naught is proportional to square of amplitude. And here we can assume amplitude of each wave as a vector with their phase difference between as the angle between vectors, and we find out the resulting vector for the resulting amplitude after superposition of the three waves. So here we can also write for coherent waves superposition we consider amplitude as vectors and find resultant by method of vector addition. This we already discussed in superposition of oscillations in concept videos. So that's what I'm applying over here. So, we are given that first wave is having an amplitude. Here we represent amplitude as A1, however the values of A1 is equals to A2 is equals to A3 is equals to A we are considering, as these waves are of equal intensities. So, first wave is say having amplitude A1. The second is ahead in phase by 30 degrees, so we can write another amplitude A2, which is equal in magnitude, is ahead with respect to the first wave by 30 degrees, and the third wave is lagging in phase by 45 degrees. So, say this is A3 and it is lagging in phase by 45 degrees. And to find out the resulting amplitude, we can treat this direction as X and vertical direction as Y. And here we can analyze resulting amplitude R is given by root of Rx square plus Ry square, where value of Rx we can write as A plus A cos 30 degree plus A cos of 45 degree, which gives us a value A multiplied by 1 plus root 3 by 2 plus 1 by root 2. And Ry, the component of resulting amplitude in y direction, here we can write as A sin 45 degree minus A sin 30 degree, and it will be in negative y direction. But here we are talking only about amplitude, so it won't make any difference. You can also put magnitudes of Rx and Ry. This A multiplied by 1 by root 2 minus 1 by 2. So, this gives us the value of R, which is root of Rx square plus Ry square. And substituting the values, this will give us A multiplied by root of, if we take the square of this and this, this will be 1 plus root 3 by 2 plus 1 by 2 whole square plus this 1 by root 2 minus 1 by 2 whole square. On simplifying this, final result we'll be getting is A times root of 6.66. This is the numerical value we get after simplifying this numerical expression. And if we further continue, we can write the resulting sound intensity can be given as IR, which we write as KR square. So, on substituting the value of R over here, this gives us KA square multiplied by 6.66, which is I naught. So, resulting intensity can be written as 6.66 times I naught. That is the result of this problem.